Good morning and welcome to Mission Control Houston and the International Space Station Update. We're joining the International Space Station Flight Control Team in the Space Station Flight Control Room here at the Mission Control Center in Houston, where the Orbit 2 team is on console at this time, led today by Flight Director Emily Nelson, who's getting help from Capcom Josh Matthew today. On board the International Space Station, the Expedition 29 crew is more than halfway through their day, which began at midnight Central Time. U.S. Commander Mike Fossum, as well as Russian flight engineer Sergei Volkov and Japanese flight engineer Satoshi Furukawa, are currently orbiting 238 miles above the Pacific Ocean, heading for the coast of California. In the next few minutes, Fossum, Volkov, and Furukawa will be passing over California, Nevada, Arizona, Utah, Wyoming, Nebraska, South Dakota, and Minnesota. They're working on their 156th day in space and their 154th day at the space station. They launched a Soyuz on June 7th and docked to the space station on June 9th, which means that they're coming up now on the end of their stay at the space station. They actually spent some time earlier today performing leak checks of the Russian Sokol suits they'll be wearing for their return home, which is scheduled for November 21st. But before they can leave, the replacements have to arrive, which they'll be doing next week. NASA astronaut Dan Burbank and Russian cosmonauts Anton Shkaperlov and Anatoly Ivanishin are already in Kazakhstan at the Baikonur Cosmodrome, where they'll be launching to the space station inside of their Soyuz TMA-22 at 10:14 p.m. Central Time on Sunday. Countdown will actually begin at 2:44 p.m. on Sunday, with NASA TV coverage of the activities kicking off at 9:30 p.m. The crew has been busy this week with pre-launch preparations in Baikonur. We actually have some photos of their preparations to show you. Photo here of Dan Burbank during an inspection of final inspection of the Soyuz that he and his crew will be riding in at the integration facility. And here Burbank is seen signing a poster of a Soyuz launch at the Korolev Museum on Wednesday. He and his crew members and their backup crew all toured that museum on Wednesday. And here is a photo of Burbank with his crew in front of the Soyuz again during the final inspection of the vehicle at the integration facility from left to right. From left to right here, you can see Anatoly Ivanishin, Anton Shkaperlov, and Dan Burbank. And here's the crew with their backup crew members, in addition to the individuals you've already seen. There's also Joe Acaba, NASA astronaut, who will be backing up Dan Burbank, and Sergey Revin and Gennady Padalka. This, again, is taken at the Korolev Museum on Wednesday, when the crew was touring to get a look at some of the history behind the Russian space program. And Dan Burbank here during some downtime in their preparations for lunch. Again, Burbank, Ivanishin, and Shkaperlov are scheduled to launch from the Baikonur Cosmodrome on Sunday at 10:14 p.m. Central Time. That'll put them on course to dock to the space station's Poisk Mini Research Module 2 at 11:33 p.m. Central Time on Tuesday. And in the meantime, Fossum, Volkov, and Furukawa are spending their day in space preparing for their own departure, again with that leak check of their Russian Sokol suits, and some packing work. They'll also be doing a few science experiments, including one that Fossum is working on an integrated cardiovascular experiment that looks at how the body's cardiovascular system reacts to being in space. This is Mission Control Houston.